Kam keng kakatamong seminar, karing hanggang lectors ang pong commentators. At magsadyata na po ba ang kanita makapag-umpisata na?
Si Bayo po, Maya Payabak po, kaya katamungan, kapara kong lectors and commentators, ketiking parokya ng San Jose. At thank you mo rin po, kaya katamung kura paroko, Yamong Paul T. Velasco. At yung kaya katamung mo naman pong guest speaker, ngayon Aldoiti, Sir Dan Maglaki. Welcome po, yung kaya katamong seminar ngeni, ating temang sharing the word of the Lord. Umpisan tayo po, yung kaya katamong pamikatagon, ngening kayabakan, king metong pangadi. At ausan ke, yung sister Lani Joy Pandi, para manimuno, yung kaya katamong opening prayer. Talakad tamo po.
King lagyunigi pa, king anak, at ning badalay espiritu. Amen. Ginoo, magpasalamat kami po, king oras a pigkalubyo kaya kami, king aldong iti. Pasalamat kami po, dininanyo kami pong pamikatagon makiramdam, para king kaya kaming kasalpantayanan. Antabayanan niyo kami pong parati, at ibubudyo kaya kami, ing kabiasnan, para anting dyan ding balang amano, o diskusyon amiyapse king seminar patungkol king amano ning Ginoo, bang lubusan mi pong ainting dyan, at ini, ing magdalake kami king kekeng malalam akasalpantayanan. Itinganadwan mi king kapamilitan ng Kristong Ginoo mi. San Jose, king lagyuning ipa, ning anak, at ning banala espiritu.
Para po king kakatamong opening remarks, ausan ke po i Sister Evangeline Bondoc, king kakatamo pong PPC President Coordinator, para king opening remarks.
Thank you, Sister Alma. May pahabak po. Anti mo yung sabi na nga mong, at yung tamo kay ni Iban, isundo tayo po itang formation tamo anting lectors and commentators kay kaktang parokyo. Doon nga tatandaan niya po itang minuna tamong seminar, March 6 ya po itan eh. Kaibat magfiesta. May antala yung bagay ni pangadwa. Uling magfiesta. Kaibat Holy Week. Kaibat atin pong milyaring aiwasan. Yeah. So, ngayon po yung topic, ibiyanin kaya katamong guest speaker tungkol yakin nung makanano tayang epektibong pasyag ing amano na ningapong Gino. So, makaramdam tampong masalese at welcome po kaniting seminar. Salamat.
Thank you, Ate Banji. Didinan mila naman po palang maya pa oras din. Kaya katamong kayabe, manalbenge ni keng live streaming po. At ngeni po, bata yung lalong akilala, yung kaya katamong guest speaker, ngening kaorasan, ausan ke po, Sister Myrin Doloiras, yung head na po ng Ministry on Liturgy, para ipakilala yung kaya katamong guest speaker.
Maya payabak po, pakilala kaya po ngayon kaya katamong talapagsalita. Mi baitia po at meragulyo, King Santo Rosario, Lourdes, City of San Fernando, Pampanga. Maging talaturuya po King University of the Assumption, Ateneo de Manila, at University of Santo Tomas. Maging LECOM, EMDC, at Lay Spiritual Director Nepo ng Junior LECOM ng Metropolitan Cathedral. Ngayon po, iya po yung kasalukuyang principal ng Mother of Good Counsel Seminary, Junior and Senior High School Departments. Let us now welcome po yung kiyakatamong guest speaker, Mr. Danilo Maglaki.
Good morning po. I would like to thank Father Paul for inviting me. Anyang kitna na ako nung pwede ko mag face-to-face mamie talk. Sabi ko, no problem, Father. Aluwa mo po itang may vaccine na. Kung nune, pache po makanya na I believe God is with us. Ne po. And thank you for the kind words na pong mag-introduce ka na ako. I would like to look at this as an opportunity mo po keng for me to share some thoughts, some ideas, experiences when I was the elector at the Metropolitan Cathedral. The idea of having a lectors and commentators guild was started by the Bishop Galang when he was director of the Metropolitan Cathedral. And I was then teaching in the seminary, and then he told me, or he asked me, to serve King Cathedral. Mag-umpisa kang group amamasa na. Makanya niya pong mibait ing Lectors Commentators Guild kanito. And we were very, very happy. Willing me, it spread like fire. Itang idea na mika talagang official mamasa detang lectors and commentators. Kasi po before, kukwala ka rin EMDC na SPEM kanito, hausan doong SPEM, o kaya ka rin volunteers. But thereafter, anyang mika Lectors and Commentators Guild na mig-train, tinring do, and then kinomission do, then mayayaluang parokya mika official proclaimers of the word of God, no po, ne po. So, makanyan po yung niya, ati ko po, Kety, just to share some of my experiences as a lector and commentator during that time, ne po. I would like to start my sharing by asking you a simple question, ne po, which nung buriyang pakibatan masikan o talakad kayo, pwede, nung ali naman, kanyo ng sarili. And the question is this. Makananuye pong lalawen, inke kayong pamaging lector o pamaging commentator? How do you look at it? How do you perceive it, nepo, as a lector and commentator of this parish? Possibly pong one of the answers that you will give is metong yang opportunity para mag-serve kay Pisamban. Others will say it is a ministry, nepo. Others will say it is a call. Nepo, it's a call or a calling. In other words, it came from the word vocation, vocare, meaning to call. So in other words, ing idea ko po makanyan, you do not become a lector or commentator, nepo, by accident. You became a lector because you were called Bakit po? Why do I have this kind of idea? Kasi po, marakala tao kaya ti San Jose na pwedeng mas magaling mamasa kaya kayo, mas magaling magkanta kaya kayo, niya po. Pero, ika yung atsuketi. Niya po. And why? Uling mayaos kayo and may kibat kayo kaya tang kayawsan na ito. So, sana po maging makanyaning kaya katamong panlalawi potang mag-serve tamo na ining gagawin ko ngayon, it is in answer or it is an answer to the call. Kaya tang kayawsan, amia bieka na ako. So it's not something that you can boast about na kakilala, marakal na makakilala kaya kauling mamasa ko. At tatandaan ko pakanta yung King Cathedral. Siyempre, ala pa pong maska nito. Ano po? Kahit makasagana ka kaking palengki, kalyando ko. Kaya mo mang kilalo. Mamasa ko po pisamban eh. Makanyan po. It's something that you can feel proud about. Pero it should not be the case. Ano po? Pag maragul, nun we call it as an opportunity to be a servant. Ano po? So, I would like to start. Okay. The role of elector has become very significant today. Why? Because churchgoers today want something that they can reflect on and apply in their daily lives. That's why they listen attentively to the readings and the homily. In other words po, then sisimbangin ni, ela mo po papacheck attendance. Unlike before, dakal po, lalo na po kaming lalaki, kung minsan karas na ning homily, lumwale, ne? Bala mo compliance siya itang munta ka kempisamban ng Domingo. Pero apansin ko po, lately, no? Na potang simbahing tao, there is something na burinang akwa o yuli kaibat na ng sinimba. Therefore, kaya be po karetang yuli na ning meto nga sisimba, maliban kitang homily ng Father Paul, detang pamamasa. Now, let me give you an example ne po. I remember, again, King Metropolitan Cathedral. After the Mass, atin pong minta King Gulot. How do you call that? Okay, atin pong minta King Gulot. Ulimbalo da karin la luluwal ding mamasa. And then, pentu ne po itang memasa. And then, lepitani. And we were surprised ne po. Ang kaya po, inge, anyang pakisabihan ni itang may masa na, Sister, ano, dakala salamat kitang pamamasa nandin. Kasi ano, may linawan ko, uling bayo ko sinimba, may patekin tatang ko, ano. Uning tang, may tiyempo po itang pamamasa, yapin tang luguran me itatang mo. Antabayanan me keng keyang ketua. Natatandaan niya po siguro yan. And because the word, the readings was done well, masalese ya pangabasa, itang pamamasa, pangaproklama, aintindyan de retang mekirandam. And ikwade ing mensahe. Now, this is just one example po kung makanano ya kaulaga ing maging role you as lectors ne po na the readings that you proclaim. I would like to use the word proclaim. I do not want to use the word reader eh. Read. You are proclaimers of the word of God. The word of God that you proclaim are the very words that people hunger for today, lalo na po ngayon yung panahon na ini. So, think about it po. Nung inke kayong pamagproklama, Eya malino. Eya masalese. Mabilis. And you post in the wrong places. Sayang po. Ne po. So, and take note. Baka lando rin, bakit bang kanita I apply dalo kem biedo? Na? That's why they listen attentively to the readings and the homily. Nyapin po, eko magtaka nung kuminsan nating criticisms. Lalo na ngayon iting live streaming, ne? Ating mag-feedback. Bakit? Posible po na mag-react lo, uling ero akakwaret ang pamamasa. Kasi, nya migaylo, si simbalo, uling, atin lang buri. And what's that? To learn something that they can apply in their lives. Okay po? Nyapin po ano, burida atin lang bakalan muli na apigunaman do at biyayan. Pigunaman de itang dindamdaking homily, pigunaman do retang readings, kay bat i-apply do lo kem pamibiebie do. So that is how significant, how important your role is as lectors. Ne po. Alright. So siguro po, after this sharing, ing maging kaita mo itang, we will begin to be more cautious, more careful, and we'll try our very, very best to proclaim the Word of God. Ne po. Okay. Now, atatandaan ko pa po ang panahon ng apong Oscar Cruz. Potang papagawayang, kasi po niyang time ng apong Cruz, dakalami nga gawang pisambanin po ang parokya kanto. And potang papagawayang pisambanin pari, ing meto nga panabili na ng apong Cruz kanto, which I remember very, very well, meto niya mo. E na sinabing, pakasan tinging retablo ne. Pakasanting yung reluklukan, ne. Kailangan masanting laring tiles. No. You know, bali po yung panabili ng apong Cruz, have a very good sound system. Kailangan yung sound system na nimpisamban mo, masanting yun. And I think, baluta na kung bakit. Right? Pero, incidentally po, masanting yung sound system yun. And that was the problem at the Metropolitan Cathedral po. Ek po balo nung gangin, problema ya pa ito. And napin po rin, may nga labasan na maging parish priests and rectors na ng Metropolitan Cathedral, balang datang, paayos na yung sound system, putang kaya, datang niya naman yung metong, paayos niya lang maliliyari. They tried putting speakers kaya tapong dome. And it cost a lot of money, pero walang miliyari. And why? Because a good sound system will be an effective way of sharing the message of the Lord. Pero take note, makanan ang gampang makananuya po kasanting ing sound system nung deng mag-proclaim dempong lectors, dempong commentators do not really do their best, masasayang po. And in comparison ko po, itang ding ingamano na ning Ginu, digpaya keng mabatong gabon at eya tumubo at mamunga. So, we have a very good sound system, that well and good, ene po problema ito. The only thing that you have to consider now is how you can make use of the sound system to lead people to God. Kapamilya, tanda po rin kaya kayong babasan, proclaim, ne po. So take note of that po. And then, that's why an effective sound system will be wasted if the proclaimers and commentators do not exert efforts to proclaim very effectively the Word of God. Okay? It is the Word of God that you proclaim. At atanda ng pupo at ang mag-train kaming participants kareng speech contest. Kumakang metong a contestant, itrain me nga duambulan at lumbulan Nepo, bang kanito po tang makipag-contest siya, he will be able to deliver his speech well. Pero nung alimbawa mo po, what comparing it with the word of God that you are going to deliver, eh po ba dapat mas dininan ming panahon and efforts bang kanito a proklamaming masalese ingamano na ning Ginoo. If we train speakers well so that they'll speak very well in conferences and contests, we should also train very well lectors who will proclaim not just any other word but the word of God so that everyone does his best. Nepo, siguro po I may sound to be very idealistic. You may say na masyado yata yung adwan mo. Pero come to think of it, if I know for a fact that what I'm proclaiming is the word of God, I will do my very, very best. Nepo. Alright? Balo ko po at the end of some period of time, lectors are invested or commissioned. Nepo. Tambala mo, it's some kind of a ceremony that will make you an official lector and commentator of a particular parish. And when you are commissioned or invested, you become an official proclaimer of the Word of God. Ketapong kutang kunan din, siguro po metong kareng pakibatuas this. Metong yang dangalan ini para keka uling me pili ka para keng kasuyuan ini. Ana po nga pong lino mandap in kanong ministry translated din kapampangan kasuyuan. So we call this as a ministry of lectors and commentators. Therefore, it is our kasuyuan as lectors and commentators, nepo. And it is a great honor on our part that we were chosen to proclaim the word of God, nepo. Again, this could be one of the answers nandin. Impa maging lector ko is a special gift, right? And we know for a fact po na epuwari po tang when somebody gives you a gift or gave you a gift, one way of showing that you are grateful for the giver is to use it. Nya po tang halimbawa ting may t-shirt ke ka o kaya blouse ke ka o kaya bag at ni katula po tang akit na nagagamitan may. We were given this special gift. Nepo, the ability to speak, right? The others. At yung pungaliwa na, midinan kening special gift ay ni. Itamu midinan tamu. And ini, gamitan tayo in order to proclaim the word of God. It is a special gift because what you are reading or proclaiming is not just any other word but the word of God. So makanyan tayo pong lawen mo rin ini. Now, makananiya kasagrado ining kasuyuan o ministry ng ining inabayan you. Nepo. The sacredness of the ministry can be seen in the closing statement. Potang mayari kang mamasa, sabyan mo, ingamano ning Ginoo. So you do not say, amano ng Pedro, ana amano ng Juan, but amano na ning Ginoo. That in itself makes the proclamation very sacred. So sana po, we will always be reminded of that. Potang whenever we say, ingamano ning Ginoo, we should be sure keng kaya ka ng sarili na we did really our best to proclaim the word of God. Nepo. Now, Because this is a special gift, we should never take it for granted. Let me ask you another question and you can answer it silently. Putang makatutok kang mamasa, do you really spend time to read it silently, quietly, and then after that, read it aloud, practicing it several times? If your answer to that question is yes, very good. Kasi you are giving time to it. You are not taking it for granted. Nepo. You consider it something we have to take it seriously, for it is a great honor to do this. Nepo. In other words po, just as you prepare, halimbawa po tang ating kampuntalan, and it is a very important meeting or what, the night before talagang mag-prepare ka masalese. You prepare your clothes, you prepare your shoes, you prepare everything. E di po dapat mas preparado tamo when we know that the next morning we will be proclaiming the Word of God. Right? Okay. It is not, maybe some of you, okay, do you consider it as a difficult task? Masakit po ba na to be a lector? Well, if you say, maligwa, kasi magkayabe ka mo, mag-enroll ka mo, you will be all, kayabe na ka, correct? Pero the question is it that easy really to be a lector? In one of the references I read, written by Monsignor Sarmiento, reading the Word of God, he says, this is a difficult task, pero it is a very rewarding experience. It is a very difficult task, but it is a very rewarding experience. Let me go back to that example that I gave nandin, ang incident nandin. Anya pong dindam na nitang kayabe ming lektor na uli na nitang kayang pamamasa, itang pamagproklama, atin niyang apasyag na itang amano, apar-ashare na itang message, kaya itang makirandam, and may linawan niyo, at may kasaya. It was a great reward for her na through her, somebody got enlightened. And take note po, makanyan po yung maliliyari po at ang sisimbala rin tao. They listen to the readings. And sana, we are worth listening to. Actually po, po tang mamasa ko kanita, yung lektor ko po, I always ask myself, do I do justice to the Word of God? Maging fair ko ba kay ngaman na ng ginu po tang magproklama ko? When I read the first reading, the second reading, or even the responsorial psalm. Kasi all of these have messages na pwedeng kapulutan ng aral ding mas ding sisimbo. Take note of that po, masakit, pero it is a rewarding experience. At tatandaan lang po in one of the parishes na may share ko, anyang niras ko kenim puntong maligwa ba yung maging lektora. And then somebody from the malatiyan po kasing kay in grupo niya, ating may mag-respond. O puwana, bakit puwana? Bakit po ako? Kasi puwana, ning kay po, gagawin mo na nga gawaan po, tang kay, pagsistida ka pa yan. No? Kay ba't po, and then another, masakit po, bakit? You have to give time to it. Timo po kanyan, Sabado nga, bak, ne po, dapat po, dahil na rin married na kaya kayo, di kayo ipibale-bale, magluto na ko ang sigang kanyan. Di nga luwa, mag-gardening na lo. Pero you are here. And then I said, balo mo ako, karing makanyan, we do not find time. We make time. Nepo. What do I mean? Siguro po uling baluyo mag-attend kayong seminar ngayon ni Ngabak, maranong kong may gising nandin, maranong kong may malengki, maranong kong may gluto, maranong kong may glinis. Bangka nito, alas 9 at yung koketi. What did you do? You made time for this seminar. So, masakit po, pero the very fact that you know na agagawa mo ini makes you very happy and satisfied. Ako, on a personal note, I can say na my being a lector for 21 years at the cathedral made where those years were very fruitful, very rewarding years in my life. Dumalang amang kasakitan, maging mayan, uli daretang ama nung poproklama mo. Now, look at this po. Nung po, baliyo po siguring sandpaper ne po. Sandpaper. Papel de lio. O kaya, rengkem pong baryo, pakiling. Ne po. Baliyo po yung pakiling ne po. Po yung sandpaper. Nan purpose doon din? To make something rough, smooth. Nepo, ulitan kaya po, yung sandpaper or pakiling is used to make something smooth. Ako yung kapanwalan ko, every proclamation that elector proclaims, every reading that he proclaims, bala mo po, pakiling la o sandpaper la, napipinwa nala in Vienna. I'd like to repeat that. Bawat bala pong readings na poproklamayo can be compared to sandpaper or pakiling na which will make your life smoother. So, nung halimbawa, lector na kang 10 years, 15 years, dakal ni apino, may pino in Vienna. When I say may pino in Vienna, it does mean na makwalta na ka, masayang-masaya na ka. No, you still go through difficulties, pero you manage to overcome those difficulties because you have those ideas na pwede mong i-apply kay Vienna. Where did you get them? From your proclamations. Pero take note, dapat nung den pong reading sa ren, they smoothen your life. They make your life better. Dapat they also make the lives of those listening to you much better. Nepo. So, masakit, pero gyu tayo po yan. Next. In proclaiming, you become a disciple of Christ. You believe that? Panwala niya po ita? Okay. And if you become a disciple of Christ, what's the challenge? You are called to follow Jesus. To be with Jesus. To be like Jesus, to be Jesus to others, and to share His life and love for others. That's how you become a disciple. That's how a lector can become a disciple of Christ. He follows Jesus. He is with Jesus. He is like Jesus. He is Jesus to others, and He shares His life and love for others. Easy? No. Pero with the many proclamations that we do and with a lot of prayers, we can certainly achieve this. This is the challenge to us. Nyapin po, eko po magugulat po at ang ating mag-comment. Dindan nyo na po ini. kutang atin lang kikritisay sa dating lektor ne po at migkamali at ating may kabalo. What do they say? Mamasaya pa mo pisamban yan? Why? Bakit po ating comment makanyan? Because they expect more from you. Nepo, I would like to repeat that. Take note of this. Uli pong tatalakad kayo, Kenny, putang misa, akilala na kayo, lalo na po tangala ng face mask na naman. And you become a public figure, and when you do not live up to those things that you proclaim, you will be criticized. They will say, mamasaya po mo pisamban. And I have heard that comment several times from other people lang yung King Cathedral, Nepo. So, please, have that in mind. Uli na ning nandin pisabyan tamo, masakit siya ni. Uli, at atin yung responsibility ay ni, mabayat yun. Pero uli ning beyata na ning responsibility day ni, ating kang dapat gawan para maging karapat dapat. At nanula rin dapat mong gawan, bang kanito, magikang karapat dapat. You have to be to prove that you are worthy of this privilege. Only beyond because, please take note of this, the Lord only deserves the best. The best of yourself. At na po kanyamang kempilublubam po, tambalo mo na, you discharge your function as a lector very effectively. Okay. So take note of that, the best of yourself. Now, your life should not serve as an obstacle to your proclamations, for it will affect the churchgoers in the reception of the word. Panwalan niyo po tali, potang ingmeto nga lector, eya masalese pamamasa. Pardon the word, imbis na makirandam lo at ma-enlighten lo, mabubuisit lo. Makanya naman pamamasa ini, di ba? Ay, human as we are, ne po. Kabitsi lugal yung kayong makirandam. Ne? If the reader read so fast, if the lector read very softly, he paused in the wrong places, aba, talagang mairita ka. And you, instead of becoming an instrument, you serve as an obstacle, maging sagabal ko. At maging sagabal yung kaya kang pamagproklama in the reception of the Word of God. So, ulitan ko po, kaya lalo na po kaya live streaming talagang, you can expect comments coming from many people when you proclaim the Word of God. Ne po. Palagi ako live streaming ngayon eh. Palagi kayo ba't mabash na ako. Alright. And you ought to be more careful about this. Alright. Do you do this? Do you examine yourselves every now and then and spend time talking to God with humility, generosity, and love? Metong po ka rin dapat na qualities na ni metong elector is that he or she must be prayerful. And to be prayerful is to establish that communion with God. Constant communication with God. And then you keep on asking yourself, do I become better because of my being a lector? Do I proclaim the word of God in the best way that I can proclaim them? Ila po rin kukutang tamo kay sarili tamo rin. And you know, many times, pota pong kukut ng tayong sarili tamo, kanita ta realize na eta po dapat stagnant. Maybe, diyasa na kang mamasa, magaling na kang magproklama. Pero, develop that further. No? Do not be minimalistic. No? Do not say, diyasa na ako eh. You know, one of the things that I noticed kanito, eh, wubari, deng readings maulit every 3 years. Nepo. So, ating kong dindamisan, meto nga lektor, binasa ako na 3 years ago, balo ko na yan, master ko na yan. Now, it's possible that you read it several years ago. Or paulit, numaluat na ang lektor, binasa mo na 10 times, 15 times. Pero aliwa mo rin, when you read it again, before your actual proclamation. In other words, eka maging kontento ketang level, kailangan upgrade ming sarili mo so that you become better in proclaiming the Word of God. Nepo. So, develop that and exert efforts and aim for excellence. Maybe you'll say that's too idealistic. Nepo. No, alipu. If we do our best, and we know that we are not contented with the least performance that we have, that will, I think that will be very, very rewarding for us. All right. Why? Kasi po, what we proclaim is not just an ordinary speech, is not just an ordinary piece of writing, but it is the Word of God. Nung napansin niyo po, paulit-ulit kayong sasabihan ng idea niyan. Bakit? Bakanta po mitanam kem puso tamo at kaisipan that what we proclaim is not just what is in a book, but it is the Word of God. Now, a lector should be adequately prepared when he proclaims. Eko po ba nung ay experience nyo ninitang may kipagnugot kayo, may kipangutkot kayo, kay ba't dinalande kayong pisamban, migmisa. And usually, patsema kanya na lang lektor, eh, nepo. Ikit na ko po ning Paris Presyo, balo na lektor kayo. So, in-house na kayo, on the spot, kay ba't mamasa kayo. Well, that is an extraordinary situation, nepo. Yan na kaman makapayali. Ne? Pero, actually po, we should never do that. Nepo, on ordinary situation. Extraordinary po ito. Pero never, never, never proclaim the Word of God if you know that you are not well prepared. That is an injustice to the Word of God. Nepo. So, nung halimbawa po, balambo po rin teachers, then professors, po tambayo lalungob kayang klase, talagang magpreparala. Bakit? They want to do justice kareng estudyante ra. So in the same token po, kayong lector, itamong lectors, baluta mo mamasa ka bukas, Domingo. So you will spend a lot of time preparing yourself because you know that you need to be adequately prepared. Now, to be adequately prepared, a lector must undergo training on the following aspects. One, voice projection and quality. Kit nang gaya po ya pong Paul no makastand atin yung microphone stand, tatal na niya po pala ni. Atin niya mo pong danger ing tatal na niyang mic. You may not know how to control the volume. Nepo, lalo na ako, medyo masikang kukway. Nung masyado yung malapit, it can be very irritating to the listeners. Nung masyado naman pong marayo, ala nung akwa. Now, ideally po, sasabihan da, deng microphone tamog gagamitan, mostly kareng pisamban, ela po multi, kay unila po, meaning manikwaya masalese, no makayarapya kay ngasbok mo. Pero ideally, 3 to 4 inches away. Eh, nepo susukdan po, ta magdala ako pa ruler, ne. Pero, a good speaker knows that potang magumpisayang magsalita, he listens to the first sounds. bangkan tabalo na nung iatras ne o isulong ne ing microphone. At inya mo pong danger ng gagamit microphone na tatalnan, lalo na karayang bayo-bayo. Ing nervyos na mayakit ne po. May kaya siguro po tinang may kaya experience kanini ne. Pamamasang ibat. Halos siya po mayari kayang nervyos na ne. Ito po. Voice projection does not mean peka masikan dili. No. Ita mong lenyo po rin kayang gulot. Nung amanan manan yung darandaman da kayo, uling elam elakakan yan, it means loud enough. Pero patsim, ating kong agit magtakap balugbog, mga spakno po eardrum din. It means you are reading too loud. Nepo. Yapin po yung voice projection nito. Now, number two is good pronunciation of the words. And in the pronunciation of words, involved po kening sounds. If you are reading, nung mamasa ko pong kapampangan, dapat ing sound kapampangan. Aliwaitang English sound, pero kapampangan la ring words. I don't know if you get my point. Nepo, kapampangan la talaga, then tonong sound sa luluwal. And then, lalo na po ikatamong kapampangan, problema tala po rin F ang poing fi. Fi, are. Ing F, F, yan eh. Ang po pa rin H. Deng hala, didi nandala. Deng hatin, didi alalo. Nepo. Take note of the pronunciation of the sounds of the language. Nepo. And then proper stress. Look at the word. There's a difference between sakit and sakit. Nepo. Now, how do you know nung ing pronunciation nanta is sakit at sakit? Akwaya po yan po tang when you read silently. Kasi po, the first step in preparing yourself is to read the readings silently. Banta, akwa mo retang correct stresses karing words. Aliwa mo po ito. Itang balu yun nung no ka rin niya pamututan ing sentence. Nang kayo po kasi lalo na kayong kapampangan, napansin ko, ing metong a sentence nung minsan apat a linyayo. Now, if you do not know where to pause, ing gawan mo, basan may itang mabilis ba ang tayari niya karas kitang period, kanta ka mang isnawo. Pero, nung balu ming pamututan, now, how do you determine that? Potang basan ming silently, you know na atok ng kukeni. That's why, kanita po yung katidal gagawan ni, it is a must potang, kasi po, kanita, Saturdays, every Saturday, lectors meet in preparation for Sunday. Bang kanita, ating mamasa, so that there will be no more mistakes the following day. And then, assignment po kanikarin lectors kento, they bring their own photocopy of the readings. Bakit? Di nandong slashes makanyan. Banda po ta mag-practice la po, baludan nung nukar la mag-pause. Kasi po, itang teksto eh, naman po pamitnan makanyan eh. So, itang photocopy, pwede yung pamitnan. So, you can practice with that. Potang actual na, potang Sunday na, balo mo noon katuknang. Those things, ne po. Limbog yata. Okay, now, proper intonation. When a sentence ends with a question mark, the voice rises. Ne po. When it is a period, the voice goes down at the end of the sentence. Basic lapuren. Right. Now, again, another, to be adequately prepared, kailangan po mabiyasing lector vocal expression. Minsan po, it is a Holy Thursday. E po, wari pa che, Holy Thursday, Friday, and po Saturday, ating narrative dramatic readings ne po. Pwede pong takala mamasa. At ing miyatasan, ano, itapuli niya, kakaatatanda ng kepo. At kinulisak laring malda. Pakuye King Cruz, Pakuye King Cruz. Eh magulo. It could have been better if nung itang may masa kanito, dininaning talagang proper emotions, expressions niya po. Again, makanano mo nga balu detang no ka rin mo ko ng detang feeling sa reto, po itang babasan ng tahimik yung pamamasa. At yung pungalaman, pari po itang basan doon ng gospel, at sinabi ng Jesus, tikdo ka nga na kayo. Walang din dami Jesus ne. Siguro po ipapumpol po itang mamasaya ka rin lines ng Jesus, bala mo din dami Jesus. Makanyan muna po itamo. So how do you determine the emotions? When you practice reading, read it first silently, identify the emotions, identify the poses, identify the proper intonations. And it's good that you have your own copy when you do that, nepo. Inipuwe ke re-recommend ka rin bayo-bayong mamasa. Kasi po to, audience contact means, makanya niya po yung audience contact ne. When you reach a period, right? Bayo ko, dengaliwa po yung audience contact, da karas keng period, lawe. Baba, mali. Dapat po yung audience contact, before you reach the period, two words, three words before. Nepo? At inta po kasing short-term memory eh. Balu mo reta ng atlong words reta, sabyan mo reta makalawe keni. Kaibat karas kitang period down, and then keni na naman, keni na naman. That's called audience contact. Aluwa po itang karas keng period lawe. Balik. No. Patseli nawe ko, ating kang sasabyan. Bala mo po when you are reading the responsorial psalm, instead of saying pakibat, ingagawan da rin mamasang responsorial psalm. Kaya rin na itang last three words, lumawe lang makanyan. That is the signal for the people to respond. Ne po. Although they nga liwa, kumanyan lo. Pero others avoid it. Ingagawan da namo, they just look. Bala mo, potang imamasa keng dalita pakibat, linawe, it is as if he's saying, makibat kayo. But he does not have to say that. Simply looking at them. Ne po. Kasi, potang basan mo ring verses na ning dalita pakibat, straight mong basan detang four lines kanito, and then after the last line, kanita ka lumawe. And then looking at them while they are responding. Okay, but you go back to the verses again. Epo. Now, how often should you have audience contact? In a short reading, once, twice or thrice. Pero patsya makabaya dapat atin. Now, nano po yung advantage na ning audience contact? It is making the audience feel that you are aware of their presence. So, limbawa po, nung manibat nanding magsalita ako, makalawe ako keng ceiling, palagay ko may maglako na kayo ne. Pero, it's good to have that contact with you, right? With your audience to make them feel that you recognize and acknowledge their presence. Okay? Pero ulitan kayo po, if you are a new lector, pwede yung pong dinan pamong panahuning sarili yung bayo ito. Kasi po yung chances are, pota kalawe yung makanyan, eno yung nabalo no ko magbalik. Ne po. Okay. That's the danger. Okay. Alright. To be adequately prepared, the lector must consider proper attire. Palagay ko ito, po problema yan because you have uniform. Ne? Pero sana po itang word uniform means one form. Ne po? Putapin po, para-para yung kulay, ibang style naman. Ne po? Alright? And then, proper posing. when you, before you say, ingamano ning Ginoo, you pause. Ako yung gagawin ko, I count 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Ingamano ning Ginoo. Looking at them. Amano ning Ginoo. Right? Okay, that's one form of audience contact na po. Incidentally po, kay audience contact, nung detang bayo-bayo, ating ko pong 2 chances na makapag-audience contact. Memorize po itang pamasang ibat, king sulat ng San Pablo, karing tao, Efeso. Pwede po nga memorize ito. I remember po, cathedral, misan siniba akong First Friday Mass, and a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippines. Dineliver niya po kasi makalawi. Philippian siya po pala. No? Alright. And then, another occasion na makapag-audience contact kayo, ingamano ning Ginoo. Alright? Next. Ingapili yung pong kasuywan, demanding yo. Natatanda ng pumisan kay Ngapalit, ito pong first session ko karela, may ilang dinalan. Anya pong magbalik ko for the second session, may pitnalo. Uli na po nitang demands na aduanan ni ministry ngayon. Muna pong demand na is good reading ability. Honestly po, ask yourself, do I have this ability? Can I read well? Can I proclaim the word of God well? Panupaya yun po, pero usually ini po yung sasabihan ko, if you think you cannot read well, nepo, there are other services that you can enroll yourself in. Nepo, kasi po, adwa na talaga nining liban nyo, magaling kayong magmamasa eh. So if you have good reading ability, check, very good. Pero hindi po madidevelop. How? After reading the proclamation silently, practice, practice, practice reading it aloud with somebody listening to you. Pero ka rin pong talasawa, aluway ng asawa yun eh. Kasi po siyempre sabi ano, ay galing mo darling, ano. Somebody po na medyo, ang tawag na po nga sa kanan, objective ya po. Ita nga sabi na, ay, mabilis. Then po nga anak yun. Then po, then kapatid yun. Aluwa mo rin po kasi when you read it aloud and somebody listens to you, akit na po ing dapat na ma-improve ba? Bang kanita po po, itang actual na mamasa ni Keti, mag-proclama ni Keti, masalisin eh. So, practice, practice, practice. Kaya mo po may tuming practice. Another demand na adwa na kaya kayo is time. One example. Inyad na kaya kayong oras sa ini. 9 to 11. Nepo. At adwa na naman yung oras kaya kayo nung mag-serve kayo na nga ba? And you know, nung ika makatutok ka kayong first mass, at medyo mumuram pa, ne? Manyaman matudtud. Right? Pero, yeah, you will make time for it. Ne po. Pakisabi mo po, Maya, patsye po mag-serve kayo, makatutok ko mag-serve. Please come 15 minutes or 20 minutes before the Mass. Bali po kung bakit. Kasi po patsye din ala 5 minutes na mo, ala kayo po, maguguluno rin nga ba yung lectors. Eda na po, balukan yan. Ikanang magkaya na, ikanang. O di po may remedyo la. Kabira-bira datang kayo. Unfair. Ne po, unfair. Kailangan po, 15 minutes, 20 minutes or 15 minutes before the Mass, magkain na kayo. Atin na kayo. And, why? You can practice again and you can dispose yourself properly. Itang aluwa itang susungakan dintang makakaibat aibat kaibat mamasa na kamo ali. May kapainawa ko, may kapangadi ko, may kapag-practice ko. Nepo. So to be fair to the other assigned lectors, please come minutes before the time. Nepo. All right. Next. Adwa na po kayo proper motivation. What is my real purpose in proclaiming or reading the Word of God? Ano talaga yung reason? Okay, and next, this is the most important thing, internalization. Making every reading a part of your own life. Nepo. Okay? Palagay ako malino, wala po rin. Now, what are the qualities of a good lector? One, sense of discipleship. Diniskasta niya po yung kabaldugan na nini. Tabang akakit da kaya kareng pamilya mo, akakit da resiping yung bali, akakit da reng estudyante mo nung tuturo ka, akakit da reng kaupisina mo, in Diyos. Uling, you read, you proclaim the Word of God. Number two, meaningful prayer life. Po sa patitang putang mamasa tamo keti yapi na ita. Ali po, a lector should spend time in prayer. But especially, importante po ni, anyang king cathedral yung gagawin po before the mass, all lectors, servers, EMDC, we form a circle and then we pray. Bayuke lungub, magumpisang misa. And then another is good oral interpretation. Itabang imboses mo, interpret mo ring emotions. Eko po balo nung may nakit na kayong mag-taping ka ring radio drama. Ito pong drama kay radyo. O ito pong pakiramdaman talaga kay radyo din, bala mo. Ating tagalan talaga, ating tumbukan talaga. Ne po? Pero actually po, makatalakad la rin kay ngarapanan ng microphone, babasan la rin ang script. Pero why is it that detang makiramdam, they are made to feel that something is going on when they listen to the radio? We call that oral interpretation. Nepo. And you can determine nung makananuming i-interpret ing reading nung aintindyan me ing pamamasa. Nung balume ing kabalduganan ing pamamasa. Again, where do you get that? When you read it silently. A lector should also involve himself in loving service. Eta po kukwentan nung pilanta ng, you know, kung minsan po malyari ni, lalo ng sunod-sunod laring misa ni, pache ating edi natangketan tutuking misa, magstay ko. Ening rule pa kanita po, itang nung mag-serve kang, hanggang pa mag-serve na ka kitang first mass, kita second mass, pwede itang mamasa ka, kahit lumwal na ka, no, ariyan may misa. And you do not count the cost. Right? Why? We call that as real loving service. And in lector, he has that love for the liturgy and the Word of God. Pinaintindihan ko, reng lectors, kaya tala niya. Ilang maging example kareng sisimba para potang sisimba la reng den tao makafocus la keng misa at ele mi papagkwento o mi papagsalita. Kasi po kung minsan napansin ko kareng ali yung parokya detang at chuketa babo mi pagsalita lo. Lalo na po potang communion. Bala mo break kito. Aliya po, it's a very sacred moment. Let people see you praying so that they too will pray. Ne po. And then good communication. So ila pong qualities na dapat i-develop yureta. Now, when you proclaim, you do not only focus on yourself, but on your listeners. Bakit po? If kabang mamasa ka, ating attention mo kayong sarili mo, chances are, nung mag-nervyos kang megumpisa, mas matinding nervyos mo as you go on. Pero pag masdan nyo po rin nga lang mamasa, may masa putang kaumpisala mag-nervyos lo. But as they go on, milalako. Bakit? Their focus is not anymore on themselves, but on the people listening to them. In other words, I do not proclaim for myself, kasi binasa ko nini. I am proclaiming for the people listening to me. Nya magproklama ako, Kenny, uling ating makirandam kanako. At deni, den tao nga reni, they hunger for the word of God. Right? Bang kanita po, mas aintindyan de at I absorb de ing message ne po. Now, if the reading is not done, minention kayo po kanini, it is like the seed that fell on unfertile ground. What a waste. Ne po. Eta po isipan na in mong importante kayong misa, itang homily na nga pong Paul. No. All the readings are also important. Ne? Kaya sayang, ita pong pamikatagon na may biyasa yung makirandam, pero eh may biyasa uling ene dindam masalese. Now, orenipuren talagang role you as lectors. When I say lectors, kaya bene po yung commentator ne po. One, to inspire people. Nepo, to inspire people so that just like you, they will appreciate the message. Tabang kapamilatan daretang pamamasa, may kaka-inspirasyon lareng si Simbo. Second, to enlighten people so that those with problems and worries will see the light. Lalo na po kayo ng panahon tamo, dakal pong, siguro po eh, dakal, marakala tao, si Patsya sinimbala po, ta simbala, tinlang dadalan. Halwa po itang magdalan eh. At tinlang dadalan problema, worries, anxieties, and it's possible that the readings will enable them to see the light. Nya po tanggay po tang muli yung sinimbo, ni kaya nakatawan eh. Uling, she or he was inspired and enlightened. And the third, panwalan niyo po tali, your role as lectors is to nourish people. Pakabsyan niyo ring tao. No? To nourish people because people hunger for the word of God, especially during this time. Nepo, bang kanita po, just like what I said a while ago, when they go home, atin lang bakalan muli. Alright? So take note to inspire, to enlighten, and to nourish. Pero all these things can only happen if your proclamation was good, was effective, kasi dindamdala masalese detang amano na pinroklamayo. Because of this, please take note of this, only good and qualified proclaimers should be given this opportunity. I repeat that, only good and qualified proclaimers should be given this opportunity. Kanita po madalas kong sisimbo King Greenbelt Chapel, King Makati. Patsya po mati ko Manila ng weekends. Apansin ko po ka rin, dengkarelang lectors, ampong commentators, they are really well-trained. And then, maging curious ko po, I inquired, ating kong kakakwentuhan, ila po pala, when one applies to be a lector or commentator, he undergoes or she undergoes a 2-year period of training, which is every weekend. Kay ba't na po nito, di nandeng trial slots. Dito pong trial slots, usually they are at noon time, tang 12 noon mass. Bakit po? Di taklaring tao ka rin eh. Baka nita nung magkalat ka man, di taklang makabalo. Ne po. And then after those trial slots, kanita kami din ng Sunday assignment or Saturday assignments. And then, you are they evaluate them so that they're informed about what else they can do to improve themselves. Kani po lulubingaman wan tamong brotherly o sisterly corrections. Sana po etamika ako nung mag-correct. Kareng sisters tamo, brothers tamo. O tangalimbawa, ikay sinimba yang lector. And then, sabi yu, siguro brads o kaya makanyan. Right? And ika na may sabyanan should feel grateful about it. Why? Patsye po kasi may comment yung makanyan ng metong atao. Metong may buri na sabyan. Kaluguran ako. Buri na, mag-improve ka pa. Right? E tapo pupunta kitang idea yung kasi kaluguran may, ay, magaling ko, ang gangali. Kasi pisan may, o kaya imame. Ay, kagaling, mame. Let us not fall into that temptation, eh po. Fraternal or brotherly or sisterly correction. We should be open karang correction sa makanyan. Uling maka-improve la po kaya katamo. Alright? Tandaan ang tapo, only qualified. And ang buri na sabihan ng qualified, detan talagang makapamasa at makabie inspirasyon. They can enlighten, they can nourish, they can inspire people. Ilan dapat may din an opportunity. Now, how valuable is the Word of God for you? If you say, very valuable, then give your best. If you value the Word of God, then give your best by proclaiming with dignity and pride. Alright? Impong makalungkot kung minsan is that some churchgoers at impong pisamba na mamielang sambuhay, yata ngayon ala natan eh. At impa po, King, kita pong sisimban ko King Lelia Tineo itang Nuestra Señora de la Estrada. Dempong sambuhay, ero bibie during, before the Mass. Bibie dala po after the Mass. Bakit po? So that the parishioners will listen to the proclamation. Pero karengalwang pisamban, atin lang bibie, bibiero resang buhay, before the Mass. So, ating aliwa, mapipilitan lang mamasa kabang magproklama kayo. Bakit? Kasi era ko haintin dyan. Nepo. And then somebody said, eh di po, banganita, haintin dyan di po masalaya si Resi Simbo. Ikabita niya kengkaing pamamasa. Ala ng readers, yung commentator namun, sabi niya, kapatad, ing mumunang pamamasa. Ano po nga po, Rick Serrano, the Word of God must be proclaimed. So that is where your role is. Iproklamaye dapat. Right? So it's very valuable. Kaya, eta po, atin po nga liwang lectors mo rin, na, lalo na po, aring everyday mass, O tangyala makatutok, dadalaro reng text to the nepo. So, makisabayan lang mamasa. Maliya po ito. Kailangan po makirandam. Kaya tang magproklama ning amano ning Ginoo. Nepo. Eko, okay. Pero you ask yourself, bakit? Now, why do they prefer to read? Due to the ineffective and boring proclamation. Right? The lector fails to get the interest of the churchgoers. Iya pong maliliyari yan pag iya pong masanting in pamamasayo. Alright. When a parish priest submits his lectors to a seminar or conference or training, metong mo po yung buri na sabihan. He is taking the ministry of lectors seriously. Bakit po? Uling balo na maulagayo ing role the ring lectors. Na actually po, to balo ko po, kareng ngenim panahon iti, masakit ting face-to-face seminars makanyan ini. Pero I'm happy that Apong Paul took the risk of coming up with the face-to-face. Yapin, when he told me, sir, face-to-face, no problem, father. Okay? Aluwa mo po rin po kasing makanyan ini. Pero, sana po, di na niyong ulagay ito. Na, the parish priest does that. Why? Because he wants you to take your role as lectors seriously. Bang kanita po, mas di na niyang mas di na niyo pang attention in kaya kayong pamag-prepare as lectors ne po. He wants to have good lectors who read with faith and feelings, skill, sincerity, and expression. I would like you to focus on feelings, skill. Balo ko po itang faith, okay ne. Pero detang feelings, detang emotions na dapat miyabot ka rin makirandam. And the skill, yung po kasing pamag-communicate makanyan, skill niya yan eh. And you can develop that skill through the years. At tatandaan ko po, I was able to asubaybayan kayo po yung karir ng Jessica Soho. When Jessica Soho started as a newscaster, itang interruption mo po, itang 5 minutes, 2 minutes, makanyan. Ay, kahit po, palpak niya talaga. Ne po, palpak niya talaga. But looking at Jessica Soho now, ay, yapin po, kanita tapuagit talagang, nun talagang dinan mo mong panahon, you can really develop that skill. Ne po. Yapin po, kareng estudyante, pansin ko po ini, sasabihan daw. Balo da ka na deng estudyante, patsing metong a teacher, maluwa na yung tuturo, ang pombayo-bayo yo. And the difference, akit me, ketang skill da. And the same is true with lectors. Ne po. Alright. And sincerity of purpose. Sincerity of purpose. Alright? Okay? To train is not a choice. In other words po, mag-training ka, ali-uling bisa ka. No. Mag-training ka, uling kailangan. To train is not a choice, it is a necessity. Alright? Next. As you prepare yourself for this ministry, dahil na po at ang mamasa kayo, reflect on the following points. One, do I consider my being a lector or commentator as a ministry? Dalawang kebay ni meto nga kasayuan. Number two, am I prepared intellectually, professionally, and spiritually? Palagay ko po, bali no, retang meaning the ring, intellectually, professionally, and spiritually. And then lastly, Do I have the gift for this ministry? If your answer to that is yes, you should nourish that gift and then develop it further. Ako po kapanwalan ko, everybody can become a lector if only he or she will train himself seriously. Nepo. Tamo po. Thanks be to God. Dakal pong salamat. Nungat. If you have questions po, pakibataan mo po nga pong Paul.
Ala ko pong kanong questions. Siguro po ay intindihan niyo ang sinabi na po ni kaya katamong guest speaker. Anyayin ako po mag-question. Puwata po ating kayong buringkutang habang atsuya po Kenny. Tayo po, sir. Ay, ito. Once again, salamat po king kaya kayong pamanagon at pamisan me itong kaniting kaya katamong seminar on the Word of the Lord. Despite po ning pandemic, ikwata mo pong miyabe-yabe hanggang sagli mo pong oras. Salamat pong dakal kay kayo, Sir Dan Maglaki, at king kay kayong wisdom and grace. May strengthen niya po in kay kaming, kaisipan, what is true and just. King kaya kaming pamagsilbi kening parokya. At maging malalam po naman king kaya kaming faithfulness, king kaya kaming duty as lectors and commentators. So for that, let us give our guest speaker a round of applause. Once again, thank you po, sir. Awsan kaya po niya mong para po king kaya katamong closing prayer.
Bayo po ita, burimila mo pong ibiya kang sir, then kaya katamong token of appreciation para king pamamian ng oras at panahon at pamidake king kayang expertise at beluan kaniting kaya katamong seminar. Dakal pong dakala salamat kayang pamamian yung oras para kaniting pamag-aral tamo. Metong po ka rin kaya katamong pastoral priorities king kaya katamong parokya yapining ongoing formation and ongoing training of our pastoral leaders and liturgical ministers. So bistaman po ating restrictions sa panikwanan tamong agampanan nini bangkanita lalo tamong makapagsilbing masalese karing kaya katamong kaparokya. Sabi napin pong sir nandin na masela niya ining kasuyuan ay ni uling ing amano na ni nga pong Gino iyeng kaya katamong papasyag. Uling masela niya ing kasuyuan ay ni kailangan tamong magsadyang masalese. Kailangan tamong misane emu king pamipasyag king amano na ni nga pong Gino nune kailangan tamo namang miyubog king kaya katamong pamibiebie. Inyapin po kailangan ing ongoing training and ongoing formation. So, maragul pong gracia ing akayabe tayo, ing metong batikan na lector, ampon commentator at talasuyo king Santa Iglesia. At emu po itang technical aspect, ing kayang dinake kay katamu, nune kabang pakiramdaman ke, penandaman ko po na itang spiritual aspect ng kakatamong ministry yung metong nang dirinan pansin. O sana po, kapamilya taning kayang pamidake, lalo tamong aluguran at ikit ing importansya na ning pamagsane at pamiyubog at pamagaral. Bangkanita, mas matula tamong agampanan ing kakatamong katungkulan. Sir, dakal pong dakala salamat king oras sa pigkalubyo at king kabias na na dinakeyo. King lagyuda po ding lectors and commentators ning parokya ng San Jose, dakal pong dakala salamat at tanggapan nyo po din ing kakaming simpleng regalo ke kayo. Salamat, sir. Thank you. Basta na po, Mr. Banking.
Parish of San Jose presents this certificate of appreciation to Mr. Danilo T. Maglaki for sharing his valuable knowledge as the guest speaker during the parish seminar for lectors and commentators entitled Sharing the Word of the Lord, given this 26th day of June, year 2021 at San Jose Parish, City of San Fernando, Pampanga. Signed, Reverend Father Paul Velasco, Parish Priest, yours truly, and Sister Myrin Doloiras, Head of the Ministry on Liturgy.
Si Bayo po, dakal pong dakala salamat. O Bayo ko po muli at intamo pong lunch king Paris Hall. O talakad ko po para king final blessing. Ing Ginoo, mantabi ya ke kayo. At mantabi ya ke kayo ing grasya at bendisyon ng Diyos, lalo na sanang palalaman ing ke kayong lugod, king kayang amano, bankanita, matula at masigasig yung apa siya giti, king amano at king dapat. At parating mantabi kay kayo in grasya at bendisyuna, in igpating anak, ating banal espiritu. Amen. So, maya payabak po at dakal pong dakal salamat.